Honorable Dinesh Mawadana, our chief guest, distinguished guests, head schools, teachers, trainers, parents, half pupils, and my dear students. Let me at the very outset extend a very warm welcome to our chief guest and everyone present here on behalf of the directorate, the principals, and the entire family of Gateway to ISAC 2020. Before I get any further, I want to thank my Gateway family for taking ISAC forward for 20 long years and organizing 11 of them. I can only say that I'm very, very proud of you. Ladies and gentlemen, an ordinary teacher of Royal College in 1967, this teacher was asked to start a new school. He was shown a piece of jungle called Kumikali. He did not have any physical resources nor any human resources. The only resource he had was his cadet platoon, because he was the cadet officer. So he went to this place with his cadet platoon, led by the cadet sergeant, and cleared the jungle. And it was his students who were the cadets who helped him to get started. It is this same teacher who founded two schools, ISAC College and Gateway College. And it happens to be that same person who founded ISAC. And it is with pride that I welcome our chief guest, who was his cadet sergeant, who led the students, cleared the jungle, and paved the way for him to start this school. My dear friends, the commanding voice that we hear in the parliament is from that cadet sergeant. And sir, I'm very thankful to you for your presence this evening. My dear students, the P stage 3 students, that is year 7, 8 and 9 students today, displayed and showed the past in Olympics and reminded us that in a few months that we will be able to witness Olympics in Tokyo. Tokyo last had their Olympics in 1964. It was a very important event for them as they were recovering from all the trouble they had in World War II. In the Olympics of 1964, there was an athlete, a Sri Lankan athlete, whom none of you all would know. For that matter, no Sri Lankans would know. But he is, I believe today, the most popular athlete that Sri Lanka has ever produced. It's not Duncan White. It's not Susanthika Jayasinghe, but this is a man called Ranatunga Karunadasa. Ranatunga Karunadasa went to Olympics 1964 to represent then Ceylon. And he had two events. First was a 5,000 meters and second was 10,000 meters. He ran the 5,000 meters and he became 47th out of 52 athletes. He completed the race by being the 47th out of 52. Thereafter, the following day, he had to do the 10,000. And 10,000 means 25 rounds on a track like this. But he had a cold in the morning. And he was finding it very difficult to run. But the person named Haru, he reminded himself that he had made a promise to his young daughter that he will somehow run the 10,000. So he decided to run. He started the race, and very first lap, he was 200 meters behind the others. Mind you, he had to run 40 laps. Halfway, he was 2 laps behind the others. And finally, when the winner, Billy White from the US, completed the race, he was 4 laps behind. And obviously, everyone expected him to stop and walk away. But Haru had made a promise for his young daughter, and he thought he would somehow complete. When he did the first round all by himself, he was jeered and booed by the Japanese. Second lap, he did again by himself. The crowd became a little silent. Third lap, there was a silent clap. And then the final lap, when he completed, he in fact ran the last 100 meters very fast. And he had a standing ovation by the entire stadium. And he completed the race. Billy White went to him and said, "You deserve this gold medal, not me." And you know what happened at the end? The Japanese appreciated it so much, because the spirit of Olympics is participation, not winning. This lesson went to the year 5 textbooks of the Japanese. For a number of years, the Japanese students were taught that participation is more important than winning through our Ceylon Haru. My dear children, today there are a few winners, but you all are participants. You have done pride to yourselves, your families, your schools, the international schools, and of course Sri Lanka. I congratulate every participant for what you have achieved this evening. We were reminded of Olympics 2020 in Tokyo, Japan. My sincere prayer, my dear students, is to see one of you, a participant who has participated in ISAC, to represent Sri Lanka in Olympics in the near future. I'm very confident you will do that for us. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. To address us next, we invite Dr. Frank Jayasinghe, patron of TISSL.